Mira, mira qué barquito, este viene ahí.
Espera un poco que se cierren las puertas. Ahora, ahora. Tú ves. ¿Vamos desde otro lado?
Te salgas del cuadro, ¿no?
Se ve el reflejo del cristal del helicóptero, ¿eh?
Thank you. okay. All right.
Yeah.
Akid Hilal Al-Rashdi, the Honorable Mr. Peter Morris, representatives of the Diplomatic Corps, Mr. Kirk, Lord Burnham, captains of the tall ships and crews, ladies and gentlemen. I wish to welcome you all here today to this ceremony and to acknowledge all those who have assisted throughout Australia to make this tall ships event this great success which it has been. The event has taken place in Western Australia, South Australia, Victoria, Queensland, Tasmania and New South Wales. For practical reasons, not all the tall ships which took part in those ports have been able to be with us today in Sydney, nor to participate in the tall ships race from Hobart to Sydney. The race was but a part of the event, an important part, but no more important than the assembly of ships in harbour to allow the crews to share their experiences and to meet the people of Australia. But the race reminded them of common experience against common elements, the wind, the currents, the sea, and all that goes with them, demanding from all patience, fortitude, courage, discipline, and above all, good seamanship. It was a great race, a friendly affair, an experience in friendly competition with the sea and the other participants, providing excellent training for the young crew members, showing all that the wind and the sea are laws unto themselves. I now call upon Mr. Kirk to commence the presentation of prizes to the vessels that have gained 9 honours in each class. Class D, a trophy donated by the Royal Yacht Club of Tasmania and the Cruising Yacht Club of Australia. Royal Ship. Class A, Division 2, trophy donated by the Royal Yacht Club of Tasmania and the Cruising Yacht Club of Australia, Asgard 2. Class C, non-spinnaker division 2, trophy donated by Tamar Yacht Club, Omoana. Class C, non-spinnaker division 2, trophy presented by the Maritime Services Board of New South Wales, Flying Cloud. Spinnaker Division 1, trophy donated by the Port of Sydney, Excelsior. Trophy donated by the Marine Board of Hobart, Sundancer 4. Class A Division 1, trophy donated by the Marine Board of Hobart, Spirit of New Zealand. Class C, non-Spinnaker Division 2, trophy donated by the Australian Bicentennial Authority, Gypsy Pearl. Vessel with the highest recorded ratio of trainees aboard, trophy donated by the Australian Bicentennial Authority, Revolution. Government of Tasmania trophy for the Tasmanian vessel with the lowest corrected time from Class A, B and C, donated by the Tasmanian State Government, Adams Apple. Government of Tasmania trophy for the first vessel to cross the finish line from classes A, B and C, donated by the Tasmanian State Government, Sovereign. The Sail Training Association United Kingdom trophy for the best performance by an Australian registered sail training vessel, donated by the Sail Training Association United Kingdom, Lewin. Cuddy Sark Trophy, a most prestigious perpetual trophy donated by Cuddy Sark Scotch Whisky, sponsor of STA races in Europe, awarded to the the vessel whose crew, in the opinion of their fellow competitors, made the greatest contribution to international friendship and understanding. Lewin.
Reminder of the great days of sail, which are so much part of our history. And more than that, at each Australian port at which any of your vessels called, you gave us in this first month of our bicentenary a thrilling start to our historic year. My wife and I have seen this happen both in Hobart and in Sydney, and we know that it's been the same wherever tour ships have gone. May you all have fair voyages to your home ports, whether they be in Australia or overseas, and may the great tradition of tour ships and of sail trading long endure. And too, that sense of achievement, that spirit of comradeship, and that wealth of experience that life at sea under sail brings with it. May all that remain with you all your lives. I'm honored to have been asked to take some part in this splendid ceremony. I hope, I'm sure, that you all enjoyed it as much as I have. Thank you.
Now let's hope that you're in good voice.